Well, I went looking for the act of law or whatever it is that I mentioned in a YouTube video at the weekend. The last one I did. So I can't remember if it was Saturday or Sunday. Anyway, I think it was Sunday. Anyway, I got distracted and wandered off to. I'll put the correct thing in the title of the video. I think it's Criminal Procedure Rules. And it's about how case management of court cases should be run. And I found this very entertaining. So I'm just going to minimise the screen. It was part one, was all I had to get to, really. I haven't looked at the rest of it yet. The overriding objective of this procedural code is that criminal cases be dealt with justly. Dealing with criminal case justly includes acquitting the innocent and convicting the guilty. Well, no, I haven't been allowed to give any evidence yet, so I don't quite know how they think that one's going to work. Dealing with the prosecution and defence fairly. Well, now I got put in a dock when I went for a aforementioned hearing, even though I didn't have to be there, so that one's out. Recognising the rights of the defendant, particularly those under Article 6 of the European Convention on Human Rights, which I mentioned last November when the police sergeant was laughing at my hernia, and the sort of the valid when I was questioning the validity of the arrest, which we now know to be unlawful. But they completely ignored all that. So that one's out. Respecting the interests of witnesses, victims, jurors, and keeping them informed of the progress of the case. Well, I've never been asked if I've got any witnesses. And even though I sent evidence off for the Magistrates' Court in November, I think it was, I haven't actually produced any evidence yet now for this case. I don't think. And if I have, they haven't bothered even fucking acknowledging that I've sent it, even though it was all signed for. So that one's out. Dealing with the case efficiently and expeditiously. Well, if we take, let's see, it went to magistrates, then it went to Crown, then the CPS realised they'd fucked everything up. Because the police hadn't got an arrest warrant for an indictable offence, so they tried to change the charges. That was the aforementioned hearing. Then it eventually, I think, went back to magistrates after that. The hearing the other week, which I had to turn up to, didn't, and nothing was said other than they'd had another little meeting to change some of the charges again. Yep, so that one's out. Ensuring the appropriate information is available to the court when bail and sentence are considered. Well, last year they lost my case file off the computer system. If you take last November, then that one's out as well, in fact. God, they're not doing very well, are they? Dealing with the case in ways that take into account the gravity of the offence alleged. No, well, they keep changing the charges, so that one's out. The complexity of what is an issue. Well, the only fucking complexity is they keep changing the charges around. The severity of the consequences for the defendant and others affected. No, they don't give a fuck about that, do they? Because they just stick you in the dock and you're not allowed to give any evidence. And the needs of other cases. Not quite sure what that one means. But let's just say that's out. Each participant in the conduct of each case must A. prepare and conduct the case in accordance with the overriding objective. Well, you didn't even acknowledge the evidence I sent you last time, so that one's scored off as well. Comply with these rules, practice directions, and directions made by the court. No. At once inform the court of all parties of any significant failure to take any procedural step required by these rules. Well, no, then they just have a secret little hearing and change the charges, don't they, when they do that? A failure is significant if it might hinder the court in furthering the. Yes, there you go. Jesus. Anyone involved in any way with criminal case is participant to in its conduct for the purposes of this rule. Don't know what that means, to be honest. So, as I said, I'm just getting the screen back, sorry. As I said, I'll look that up. I'll cut whatever that is the title of the video. But as we can see, neither the police nor the CPS have followed one single rule. And this is dated 2015, so I'm assuming it hasn't changed since then. Never mind. See you all later.